Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we look at bearings and distances.
Bearings and distances.
Now before I proceed, there is
something that I have to tell you that is very, very important. Although some of you are familiar with it.
Look at it. I will start with the word. By introducing to what you call four cardinal points.
What did I say? Four cardinal points.
So these four cardinal points.
So in four cardinal points,
this place is the north. Is the north. Abi? N. Abi?
Can you see now?
Yeah, let me use N to listen. N is north. It's N. I think the north. N. Then this. This is what is south. I use N to represent south. So this direction is what N, north. This direction, like this downward, is what is south. This direction is what east. E, then this direction is west. W is west. This west. Here we call the four cardinal points.
Now I want to tell you something. I want to tell you something very, very, very important.
Now, in bearings, let me tell you, let's assume
Someone is here.
This, a man is here.
At this point.
And another man is here. This point A, this point B.
And you have to find the bearing of P from A. They say find the bearing of P from A, we start with four cardinal point to point A.
Then you want to find the angle. Bearings means what? The angle between that what? Is the angle between this man and this man. It's called bearing. The angle between this man and this man. So, you want to start the bearing. You start from the north. You start from where? North. Have you seen now? Let me stop there. You start from the north. Now, here. This one cardinal point is what? N. Can you see now? So, this place is what? Right hand triangle. Have you? Which is 90 degrees. Another right hand triangle, which was 90 degrees. Another right hand triangle, which was 90 degrees. Another right triangle, which was 90 degrees. So the angle here is 360 degrees. 90 plus 90 plus 90 plus 90 plus 90 equals 360 degrees.
Now, don't worry, you understand. I'll explain the four cardinal points to you. And now, let's move to eight cardinal points. That was very simple to me.
Let me draw the four cardinal points first. Abi? This north and this what north, this south, this east, and this west. Then you draw another line from here again, like this, another line like this.
Can you see now?
Let me draw it now. So this another line. So now this line is between north and west. It's between what? North and west. So that'll be what? You start from N, that'll be north west. It should be what? North west. Now this line is between what? North and east. This will be what? North east. You start from north. And this line is between what? South and east. North and you start with south and west. You write what that'll be what? South west. This is what it was south and that'll be what? South east.
You want to call the eight cardinal point?
North, south, west, east. So the line between north and west is what? Northwest. North and east is what? Northeast. South and west is what? Southwest. South and east is what? South.
It's because called eight cardinal.
So the notes, don't worry. Start with four cardinal points. Draw the diagram.
Eight cardinal points. Draw the diagram. This is your notes, please. But try to understand what I'm explaining to you. Before I proceed, there's what I want you to understand.
Now this is what? Alternate angle. As what you let me draw the alternate angle. Let's do this on that alternate angle. Let's have something like this. So this angle and this angle are what?
Equal. Can you see now?
Alternate this angle and this angle are what? Let's see.
So this angle and this angle are the same.
Is that clear to you now?
Not like this one. This one is not part of the roots. Then, you have something like this again. This angle and this angle are what?
Equal. Is that clear to you now?
Alternate angle. And you have something like this. This arm and this arm are what?
Equal.
Like this one. Let's say this is A and this is B. Say A equal to B. This is alternate arm. Go like this one. Alternate arm. Why is alternate arm used? This is what alternate. Can you see now? They are like alternate angles. They got something like this too. This angle is equal to this angle too.
Can you see now?
Let's say this is X and this is Y. X. X equal to Y. Listen. Alternate
angles. So try to draw this diagram. It's part of your notes. First and right. Exactly. First and right. It's part of your note. Now let's look at this example now. Now let's continue. Now let's look at this. Before I give an example, let's look at this. Now look here. These words, then that you want to start your bearing, you start with notes. You start with notes. The next time you have something like this. This from here, from here to here is what is the right angle triangle. Can you see now? And it's what 90 degrees. And let's continue from north again. Then from here to this place is what? This 90 degree, another 90 degree, 90 plus 90 give us 180 degree. Can you see it now? Hope you are getting it. This angle is what 90 because the right angle triangle is 90 degree. Then if you extend it like this, 90 plus 90 give us 180. This is what 180. So this angle is what 180 degree. Is that clear to you now? Now let's continue. Not again. This angle like this, let's find it. Let's find this angle from here to here. Let's find it. This 90 degree. Then 90 the right hand triangle, another right hand triangle. 90 plus 90 is what? Abi? It's 180 plus this one is what? Another right hand triangle. That's plus 90, 180 plus 90, 270. So it means from here, this angle like this is what? 270 degrees. Okay, hope it's clear to you. 270 degrees. Hope you are getting it. It's not hard at all.
So this place is called the first quadrant. The first quadrant. And the first quadrant, the angle must be between what? 0 and 19. Angle between 0 and 90. At least the angle must be what? Must be less than or equal to 90 degrees.
If the angle is what? Is 1, 5 degrees, 6 degrees, 7 degrees, it must not be more than 90 degrees. But if the angle is more than 90 degrees, 91, 95, 100, 54 in second quadrant. This is the second quadrant. Second quadrant. I mean, the year. The angle is what? Is less than or equal to 180 degrees. Is what? Is greater than 90. Yeah? The angle is greater than 90. Then less than 180 degrees. This second quadrant. It means the second from year to year, the angle must be maybe 95, 96. The maximum should be what? 180. So it will fall in the second quadrant. And the third quadrant is here.
From here is third quadrant.
And the angle must be what? If the angle is greater than what? 180 degrees. Here, the angle is less than 90 degrees. Here, it's what? Greater than 90 degrees. Greater than 90 degrees. Greater. Do you understand? Greater than 90 degrees. Abi? But here, is what? Greater than what? 180 degrees. From here, the angle is what? Is between 0 and 90 degrees. That is the first one, first quadrant. Then, if the angle is what? Is greater than 90. Abi? And less than what? Abi? Less than 180. Second quadrant. And this one, greater than 180 degrees, then less than what? 370. 270 degrees. 270 degrees. Instead of 180 degrees, then less than 270 degrees. So try to copy this inside your notes. Don't worry, the time you start example, you understand.